Is there an optimal idle timing for every camshaft? And how do you know if you have too much or too little? Okay, so in terms of ignition timing at idle, camshaft irrespective of that stock or a larger, more aggressive cam, what we need to understand is we can't really monitor engine torque like we would when we've got the engine running under load on the dyno. So we're not necessarily going to be able to find MBT, but that actually doesn't matter. In most instances, MBT is probably going to be somewhere in the mid to high 20s at idle, or thereabouts anyway, but we don't actually want to be at MBT at idle. We purposely want to have the timing retarded a significant way from MBT, and the reason for this is that most engine control modules will use what is referred to as idle ignition control. So this is a way of very quickly making adjustments to the engine RPM at idle. So the way this works is that by advancing the timing towards MBT, we're going to end up increasing engine torque, and when this happens at idle, the engine RPM will also increase. Conversely, if we retard the timing away from MBT, the engine torque drops and so does the RPM. So the engine control module is doing two things. First of all, it will be manipulating either the drive-by-wire throttle position or the idle speed control solenoid if it's a non-drive-by-wire engine to make course adjustments to the idle speed. And then it will also be rapidly advancing or retarding the ignition timing to also control the idle speed in a slightly more fine way. So what I'm getting at here is if we tuned the idle ignition timing to MBT, we wouldn't have that ability to advance the timing and increase idle speed. So if we're saying that our MBT timing is possibly in the mid-20s, I generally want to be somewhere in the region of about maybe 16 to 18 degrees at the normal idle timing, and that gives the ECU the ability to both advance and retard. One thing I will mention here, because you have mentioned with a camshaft, or we have mentioned every camshaft, as we get larger with our camshaft grinds, more lift, more duration, more overlap, we naturally get that lope, that cammy idle, that is one of the attractions of fitting an aggressive camshaft. So what this means is that naturally with a big cam, the idle speed is going to fluctuate up and down more. And we do need to take this into account, because if we don't make adjustments to our idle control tuning, the ECU is going to actually be chasing those natural lopes or oscillations of the idle speed, and we don't want that. So basically dulling down some of the idle control authority is pretty important with a really big cam in order to get a nice stable idle speed. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.